Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. 4 score and 7 years ago, our fathers brought forth upon this continent the new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. Note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here. Nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, and for the people shall not perish from the earth. Thank you.
Thank you. President
of the United States,
I was present at the first Pan-American Congress in Washington, D.C.
Thank you.
dream greatly and strive to make their dreams come true, who can kindle the people with the fire from their own burning souls. The leader for the time being, whoever he may be, is but an instrument to be used until broken and then to be cast aside. For the time being, whoever he may be, is but an instrument to be used until broken and then to be cast aside.
We should lead the way, and all doubts as to our constitutional authority should be resolved in favor of our stepping forward as a nation with the power, the wealth, the fortune, and the opportunity that God has given us to help along the movement of Christian progress toward permanent peace.
Thank you. affairs of the world can be set straight only by the firmest and most determined exhibition of the will to lead and make the light the right to be.
The greatest favors that can be bestowed upon the American people is economy in government. Thank you.
This campaign is more than a contest between two men. It is more than a contest between two parties. It is a contest between two philosophies of government. America is a land where men and women may walk in ordered liberty.
Will not always run smoothly. Sometimes we will be rising toward the heights. Then all will seem to reverse itself. Start down.
1941, a date which will live in infamy.
Franklin Roosevelt died, I thought there must be a million men better qualified than I to take up the presidential task. But the work was mine to do, and I had to do it, and I've tried to give it everything that is in me. And believe we have contributed to the welfare of this nation and to the peace of the world.
Society's future. We, you and I, and our government must avoid the impulse to live only for today, plundering for our own ease and convenience the precious resources of tomorrow. Thank you. During the long lane of the history yet to be written, America knows that this world of ours, ever growing smaller, must avoid becoming a community of dreadful fear and hate, and be instead a proud federation of mutual trust.
Only a few generations have been granted the role of defending freedom in its hour of maximum danger. I do not shrink from this responsibility. I welcome it.
Organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win, and the others too.
Has thrust upon me the awesome burden of the presidency. I am here today to say I need your help. Not to pause, not to turn about and linger over.
Each moment in history is a fleeting time, precious and unique. But some stand out as moments of beginning, in which courses are set that shape decades or centuries.
Like our forefathers, we know that if we meet the challenges of our own time with a common sense of purpose and conviction, if we remain true to our Constitution and to our ideals, then we can know that the future will be better than the past.
made equal, that they are endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But we know that democracy is always an unfinished creation. Each generation must renew its foundations. Each generation must rediscover the meaning of this hallowed vision in the light of its own modern challenge.
For me, there was a fork in the river, and it was right in the middle of my life.
Thank you.
a date which will live in infamy.
I never meant to go into politics. It wasn't my intention when I was young. I was happy with my career in the entertainment world, but I ultimately...
Holding us steady in times of change, a symbol of hope to all the world. And freedom is at the very heart of the idea that is America. Giving life to the idea depends on every one of us.
Thank you.
rests our hope. All that America will mean.
In the next century, it is our great good fortune that time and chance have put us not only at the edge of a new century in a new millennium, but on the edge of a bright new prospect in human affairs.
America is a young country, full of vitality, constantly growing and renewing itself. And even in the toughest times, we lift our eyes to the broad horizon ahead.
Thank you. Journey in, that we did not turn back nor did we falter, and with eyes fixed on the horizon and God's grace upon us, we carried forth that great gift of freedom and delivered it safely to future generations. Thank you.
stops right here and stops right now.
I stand here tonight, having served as long as about any one of you have ever served here. But I've never been more optimistic about our future.
Thank you.